So good morning students. The last video we have seen basic structure of C program, how to execute C program, and we started with the tokens, right? So identifiers and keywords already explained. Now we are going to see variables. Variables are identifiers. Variables are identifiers. And then why we need variable? Like we'll go back to our program. This is our program. This is our program. So this program is for to add two numbers, right? Num1 and num2. That numbers are 10 and 20, right? And so here num1 and num2 are known as variables, and even result also variable. Num1, num2 results are variable. Then what is variable? See, this 10 and 20 are input, right? And I have given input to my system, and I want to store that input in the main memory. So how to store these inputs in the main memory? So it will be storing in the main memory, and that main memory how to give some name. So where 10 is stored in the main memory, and that particular position I named it as num1. And where I stored number 20 in the main memory, that particular position I stored named it as num2. And the answer 10 plus 20 is 30. The 30 also how to store in memory. I stored in memory, right? So that position where I stored in main memory, I named it at that position, that particular position I named it as result. So variables are. Variables are identifiers, is used to store data in memory for later use. Variable value may change during execution. So that is here. See, num1, num2. The first line I have saved num1, num2, right? Later I can use that num1 and num2. So I stored 10 and 20 in the main memory with the name num1 and num2, and later I can use that num1 and num2, right? And it will be changing. Like instead of result, I can write num1. Num1 I can write. See, if I write num1, that value is changed. I'll debug. After debugging, no, num1 is equal to. I'll run. Num1 is 30, right? First num1 was 10, now it is 30. So the value is changing. Variable value is changing. Hope all of you understood variable. So in our program, num1 and num2 are variables. So it's used to store the data. And like your data, you have to store in the main memory. So like in that position where you are storing your data, that position you are naming with the help of the variable. So in that address will be address 1000, or address will be 1500, or address will be 2000. But using that address is difficult, right? So instead of using that address, we are naming that particular address position is named as num1 or num2, like that. And variable name can consist of capital letters A to Z, lowercase letters A to Z, and digits and the underscore characters. All alpha, your identifier rules are applicable here because variables are identifiers. The first character must be letter or underscore. Blank space are not allowed, and special characters also not allowed, and keywords cannot be used, and variable names are case sensitive, and value of the variable can be numeric or alphabetic, whatever it is. And variable type can be char. That this line I'll explain later. These two lines I'll explain. Last two points I'll explain later. So all your identifier rules are applicable to variables also, because variables are identifiers. Variable, next topic is variable declaration. What is variable declaration? See here in our program. See, num1 is variable, right? And value of num1 is 10. And num2 is variable, and value of num2 is 20. Then result also variable, value of result later we will get here. Later we will get, right? Result, what is the variable? Result is equal to, result value is 30 will get it. Then what is this int? What is this int num1 num2 result? I have written int num1 is equal to 10, comma num2 is equal to 20, comma result. What is that? This is known as variable declaration. This particular line is known as variable declaration. Then what is variable declaration? Variable declaration is asking the operating system to reserve a piece of memory with that variable name. So I have given that I have selected my variable name as num1. But why we need variable? We need variable like to name it name a memory, right? So we are how to ask your operating system with the help of the variable declaration. And how to declare variable? Variable there is syntax. That syntax is type variable name. So there are two syntax. So there are two way you can do. Either like this you can do or different lines also. Int num2 semicolon int result. Different lines you can use or same line. So type variable name semicolon or in the same line type variable name comma variable name same line or different line you can use. Then what is this type that we'll see later. So this is the variable declaration syntax, type variable name. So in your program type is int variable name, num1 is equal to 10, or type variable name in type is int, variable name is result. So int result means I'm telling to operating system reserve a space and that space name is result to store my answer. And int num2 is 20 is equal to int num2 is equal to 20 indicate reserve a space, that space name is num2 and the value of that space is 20. Hope all of you understood what is variable declaration and variable assignment. Assignment in the sense, see here, what is the difference between int result and int num2 is equal to 20? This is just a declaration. This is known as assignment. Int result is I have declared variable result. Here along with the declaration, I have assigned value also. So int num2 is equal to 20 indicator. Reserve a space, that space name is num2 and value of num2 is 20. Int num1 is equal to 10 means reserve a space, that space name is num1 and the value of num1 is 10. Int result is reserve a space and the space name is result. Value of result we have not assigned. Hope all of you understood what is variable assignment. Variable assignment is a process of assigning a value to a variable. Int length is equal to 100. Int length is equal to 100. Then next topic is data type. Data type is identify the type of the variable when it is declared. Identify the type of the return value of a function, identify the type of the parameter expected by a function. These two statements you will understand when we go for the third module. First, I'll explain identify the type of a variable when it is declared. Take your program. Here it is written, int num1 is equal to 10, right? So, reserve a space, the space name is num1 and value of space is 10. So, what is int? Int is indicating we are reserving space. That space can hold only integer values. That is the meaning of int. I'm reserving a space. That space can hold only integer values. It can be 10 or it can be 5 or it can be 100. Any integer values. But I cannot hold a here. I'll get error. Because I told to operating system reserve a space, that space name is num1, it is going to store only integer value. But here I try to give character value. Understood what is int data type? A data type is type of the variable. So identify the type of the variable when it is declared. That is data type. These two statements we'll learn later. And there are different types of data types.